And happy Thursday, everyone. 54 degrees yesterday was Burlington's high temperature. Our low was 37, which was above our normal high temperature for this time of year, which is 33 degrees. Record of 61 didn't quite get there. We could be flirting with more record temperatures, though, later on this week. In the meantime, it is still incredibly warm in Burlington, 48 degrees right now. In Burlington, much cooler though elsewhere. Plattsburgh is down to 32, 42 in Newport, not bad there, but 30 for Montpelier and Lebanon. Everyone's a little different this morning, but everyone is well above average. We've got some clouds that have built in and actually allowed to trap some of that heat that we absorbed yesterday, so it's not going to drop a whole lot. In fact, some temperatures could rise a little bit later on this morning. Besides the clouds, you might find a couple spots of fog, so watch out for that. You'll certainly notice the mud and puddles that are everywhere as well, with those mild temperatures continuing to melt some of that snow and ice. This morning, of course, temperatures will continue to stay warm, getting up into the low 50s by noontime, upper 50s for our high temperatures, with a couple of showers by the afternoon hour. Shouldn't be a huge issue. You can see a few of those passing through by around dinner time or so by the time you're headed out from work. Very few of them, and light if you get them at all. Overnight tonight, partly cloudy. Tomorrow is much of the same at first, but the afternoon will bring more showers. It is a warm front that's going to be moving through, prompting some of these scattered showers, light to moderate possible. Not everyone will get them. Then that warm front is off to the south, north of us rather, and is going to pull in warmer and warmer air. We do keep the clouds, and we have a better chance for more showers as we head into Saturday night. Look at that jump in temperatures. In fact, even some of our cooler days over the next 5 days are still well above the average of about 33, which means our ice will be melting. Friday evening into Sunday evening, we've got an aerial flood watch in effect for most of Vermont and northern New York. For those warm temperatures could create some ice jams, so keep that in mind if you're along our river areas. Saturday is a big day to watch. We start off with just a few light scattered showers. Heavier rain and wind will arrive for the Saturday night, and then a cool down behind it for Sunday.